afternoon, folks. Big Bo here with another great small Class A value from Parkway RV Center. Folks, I just got in this 2002 Winnebago Sightseer, model 27C. It's only 27 feet long. It's only got 44,000 miles. One power slide out. This is a nice little motorhome, folks. And I don't have to tell you buyers out there looking for small motorhomes how hard it is to find any Class A under 30 feet long. I put two online yesterday and I've already sold one, and the other one's just a day or two from going out as well. So these things sell literally as fast as I can put them online. This particular one is a Winnebago, which is a brand I'm very, very familiar with. I currently own a Winnebago myself and have owned one in the past as well. This is a really nice unit, 27 feet long. It's on the Workhorse chassis. It's got the 8100 Vortec V8 with a class leading 340 horsepower. Excuse me, folks. 340 horsepower, 450 pound-feet of torque, which is the most powerful gas engine you could buy in 2002 and was all the way up to 2007. Got the awning topper on the slide out. You know what I like about Winnebago, folks, and this is one reason why I've owned them. This is the only brand that builds 80% of their own parts in-house. You know, other brands, other manufacturers, they buy 90% aftermarket parts and assemble them. That's why when you get a motorhome that's more than 5, 6, 7 years old, you can't hardly get parts from the factory for them. You don't have that problem with the Winnebago, folks. They keep templates to all the parts they have made going back to the late 60s. So it doesn't matter how old your Winnebago is, whether it's a 2002, a 2012, or a 1982 model, you can still get just about any part for it direct from Winnebago. This unit's got a 4kW Onan generator, runs great. I've got it powering everything up inside right now. 27 feet long, folks. This is actually shorter than your average Class C motorhome, and you get all the benefits of a Class A, like more living space, more inside and outside storage, bigger tank sizes, etc. As you can see, for the year model, the striping and finish looks great. There's no delamination. Winnebago is the only brand that has a standard fiberglass roof, all fiberglass, not a rubber roof. You know, other brands use rubber roofs and you have to go up there and service them and seal them every year. Kind of a pain, folks, but you don't have to worry about that with the Winnebago product because everything they build is fiberglass roof. Plus, it's a crowned roof too, so it's better aerodynamics, and because it's crowned, you don't have standing water on the roof either. Michelin tires, double power steps. We're going to make sure the awning looks great. You know, this is a nice little motorhome, folks, and for those of you looking for them, I don't have to tell you how scarce these things are to find. 44,000 miles, runs and drives great. We just drove it 250 miles in from South Carolina. Let's take a look inside this little 27C. As we step inside, folks, I want you to know there's no smoke, no pet odors. And after you purchase this RV, my RV techs, my certified RV techs, are going to take this motorhome and go through a very extensive inspection. And if you want a copy of our inspection checklist and what it covers and what we check on these RVs, which is about twice what other dealers check on them, just contact my non-commissioned sales department. They'll be more than happy to email you or fax you a blank checklist. And folks, it's, you know, most RV dealers, they do a 50 or 60 point inspection. We do, last time I checked, it was in the 120s as far as many points that we check out. It's got the HWH hydraulic leveling jacks. We're going to make sure it works great. Got an HDTV upgrade already installed. 44,000 miles, Workhorse chassis, heated power mirrors. Of course, got the auxiliary start, got the CD stereo up front. Both these seats swivel for party seating. Carpet looks like new. Now, folks, it is missing a little chair right here. I just want to let you know off the bat that the chair is missing. It wasn't in here when we got it, so, which is good because I know a lot of people, they may want to put a bookshelf or a little entertainment center right here. You may have other uses for this space beside a chair, so I just want to make that clear. This unit is missing this little small swivel chair right here, which is pretty much useless anyway. But you do have a table booth that makes a bed. And you've got the really nice cabinets, hardwood cabinets. Winnebago has their own cabinet shop. Winnebago is the only brand that actually builds their own frames. They buy the chassis, of course, from Ford or Workhorse. But before, where they went through Lippard or other places to get their frames, they weren't real happy with the quality that they were getting from their vendors on their frames. So they're the only RV manufacturer that has an in-house frame shop. So this metal frame on this RV, this cage frame, is all built by Winnebago exclusively. Like I said, just about anything in here, from the furniture to the cushions, you can get direct from Winnebago. Doesn't matter what year it is. Even the cabinets. As you can see that crowned roof where it's got the, there's no standing water on it. I've got the air conditioner on. It's blowing ice cold. And of course, we're going to check it with our RV techs, but let's see what is running here. Of course, now I haven't had it on very long, but we're sitting here in a gravel parking lot with no shade, and it's close to 90 degrees outside. Look at that, folks. We're blowing low 40s out of the vents and probably going to get into the 30s. Obviously, keeping this thing cool is not going to be a problem. But I always like to show that anyway, because I see, you know, I watch other people that do videos on YouTube on RVs, and they always say this is cold, that's cold, but they never prove it. And of course, you know, we're going to go through that extensive checklist. We're going to make sure all that works anyway, but at least you know from the get-go that everything works just from cranking the generator up. And it does, folks. I didn't even have to change a light bulb in here. Refrigerator, got the Norcold RV refrigerator. And it's probably getting cold enough to work. Many of you know, you got to run these things several hours to get cool, but I'll go ahead and, I mean, we're still in the 50s in the fridge, but obviously it works, because it would be a lot warmer than that if it didn't. And if this thing was on for a few hours, of course, I would go ahead and show it to you already operational. But rest assured, this is part of our checkout sheet. We run the refrigerator for a minimum of 24 hours, 12 hours apiece on gas and 12 hours on electric, just to make sure that it's not going to give any long-term problems. Because most RV dealers, they just turn the fridge on long enough to make sure it's cold. But folks, we actually simulate an overnight camping experience when we check out an RV. That's why we run the generator for 24 hours. That's why we run the roof air for 24 hours and the refrigerator for 24 hours, just to make sure that you're not going to have any issues as the appliance warms up and it gets or cools off and it's being used in real time. But I'm going to tell you, this is a nice RV. The glass looks great. Still got the original Winnebago windshield. It's only got 44,000 miles, so not a lot of wear and tear on this model. You've got a kitchen right here, residential style stainless steel double sink. You've got a range top and oven. You've got a microwave. All the cabinets look real deep storage. Got some drawers over here, overhead storage. Got the carpeted headliner with a sound deadening material that really helps reduce road vibrations and helps insulate the RV as well. And let me show you a thing that I only do with Winnebago's, and this is what they actually, when I took the factory tour, they taught me this. What you do, go into any RV that's not a Winnebago and do what I'm about to do here. Go up to the roof and punch it. Folks, there's no rattles, no vibrations. I punched that pretty hard. And if you did that with another brand, it's going to give. It's going to have vibrations. You might even see like a light lens pop out or something. But Winnebago roofs are so solid that it's like punching a brick wall. And that's how you tell how well one's built, because the roof, like any RV, is the most critical part as far as keeping it structurally sound, and you want as heavy-duty a roof as possible. And you get that with a Winnebago. I mean, you see Winnebagos that are 40 years old still on the road today. So, and they've been around since 1955. This company has been around a long time, and obviously they know what they're doing. In fact, their name's pretty much, Winnebago's a synonymous name for Class A motorhomes. You tell somebody you drive a Winnebago, even if it's a Fleetwood or a Monaco or Holiday Rambler, they know you drive a Class A. because that's kind of the synonymous name for any Class A motorhomes, Winnebago. Got a private rear bedroom, and this is pretty neat too, because this is only a 27-foot motorhome, so you normally don't get a really good-sized bedroom, but this one does have it. Got a queen island bed, got a nice mattress, got a headboard, got overhead storage, got a nightstand on one side, mini closet right here. You got a privacy curtain, so you can separate the bedroom from the bathroom and the rest of the coach. Got a split bathroom. You can look around the skylight. You can see there's no stains or any signs of any water leaks. You can tell it's not been used much because look, the sticker by the drain is still on it. You know, usually when people walk around these and take showers, they wear that sticker out with the water, but it's still got the sticker on it in good shape, which is very unusual. You've got a private water closet on the other side, and you've got a upgrade Sealand. This is a China RV toilet instead of the plastic one. Of course, you've got storage in here, you got duct work, you know, which is really important to look too, folks. See, you've got heat duct worked in here. A lot of manufacturers forget to duct the water closet for heat, and what happens is when you winterize one, if you've got any water at all in your toilet valve, they bust and break. But they've actually got duct work in here, so if you are doing any kind of wintertime camping, you don't have a spot in here that might freeze. But you do have the lavatory area, really nice, looks great. Got a vent fan in here. Of course, you got a privacy door, and you actually open this door up all the way, and it makes a privacy barrier for the bathroom from the rest of the RV. You know, folks, it's a nice, clean RV. We're only asking $24,900, and that includes that very extensive RV checkout sheet. And, of course, like I said, we're more than happy to send you a copy of that sheet so you can see for yourself how thorough we go over these RVs. And, folks, I'm going to tell you, we've been doing this 48 years. We're not a new company by no means. 48 years. Three generations, family owned and operated since 1968. You know, we're one of the largest and most successful independently owned independent used RV dealers in the country. We sell over 500 plus used RVs a year, and this year we're probably going to break 600 if our trend continues. And the reason why we sell so many RVs is you get on our website and you look at what we offer and the prices that we sell them for. Then get on other RV dealers' websites. Get on RV Trader. Get on RVT. Get on eBay. Check what other dealers are asking for our same make and model RVs. And you're going to see our prices are thousands of dollars less. And that's why, folks, we've been in business a long time. Everything we own is paid for. We don't have mortgages. We don't borrow money from banks like other dealers do to buy inventory, which is called floor planning. And you know, when you don't have to do all that, when you operate off your own money, you don't have to make a killing on every RV you sell. You know, these other RV dealers, you know, they pay thousands of dollars in interest when they finance these RVs themselves in order to be able to buy them. And they just pass those costs along to the customers. When they have a $10,000 mortgage payment every month, you know, that they have to pass that cost along to the customers. When they have 300 employees they have to pay every week working for them, they have to pass that cost along to the customer. When they spend millions of dollars a year on billboards, TV advertisements, and sponsoring stuff like NASCAR, again, they pass that cost along to the customer in the form of higher prices. More overhead means higher prices. Folks, we've got 150 to 160 used RVs out here. We don't do any advertising except the internet. We don't owe anybody anything. We have the title to everything we sell in our lot, in our safe. And other dealers can't say that because they finance RVs just so they can buy them, and they actually have to give the title to the bank until they sell it and pay it off. And again, they incur a lot of money and interest when they do that, and they just pass that along to the customer in the form of higher prices. That's one reason why our prices are so low. And second of all, we're a high-volume dealer, so we don't have to get rich off every RV we sell. We sell about 20 a week. And one of my grandfather's favorite sayings was, and this is kind of our unofficial business motto, you make your dollar with 10 dimes instead of 4 quarters. In other words, we got to sell 10 RVs to make what other dealers make on 4 of them. But the buyers like it because they get a lot better deal. And they got such a good deal that they're going to send their friends and family to us, and they're going to come back to us when they're ready to upgrade their RV because we saved them a lot of money. Now, we have to work harder to make our dollar because we have to sell them more RVs, but at the end of the day, we still made our dollar. Our buyers are happier than the people that went and overpaid at other RV dealerships, and we know they're going to be back, and that's why we've been in business for 48 years, folks. If you're in business as long as we have, you're doing two things right. You're selling a bargain, and you're selling great RVs and treating your customers right. And obviously, that's three things, but you get my drift, folks. I'm going to tell you something else that we do or don't do that other dealers do. We don't charge you extra fees. You know, you go to these other RV dealerships, you're going to pay $5,000 to $10,000 more for the same RV just because of the overhead issue like I talked about earlier. They got higher overhead, so that means they have to mark the prices up more. Then, just to add insult to injury, they're going to start adding on fees. And for those of you who have bought from other dealers, you know exactly what I'm talking about. They're going to start adding a $395 dock fee, $895 prep fee, just to check one out that, of course, we do for free, $150 title fee, $100 tag fee, temporary tag fee. Time you get out of there, you've already paid about $200 to $2,500 in extra fees. And these dealers do it every single day, folks. All those fees are 100% dealer profit. It's just a scam that the dealers made up so they can make extra money and not appear like they're making extra money. But if you ever paid any fee besides the sales price and the sales tax, you got ripped off, folks. At Parkway RV Center, 48 years in business, we charge no extra fees. Another thing that we don't do that other dealers do is we understand that many of you looking at our RVs are going to need to finance. You know, over 85% of RV shoppers finance their RVs. So that's a fact of life. We've got the same lenders you're going to get at the big new RV dealers. But our interest rates are so much lower. They start out as low as 3%. And you can't even go buy a brand new RV and get a 3% rate. And I'll tell you why. Other RV dealers have learned to exploit people who need to finance RVs by marking interest rates up over what the bank approved you for. In other words, they never disclose in any of their advertisements, and their salespeople are trained never disclose what their interest rates start at. Well, we're the opposite. We're proud of the fact that we get several buyers a week done at 3% interest rate. And what they do, just like us, they get you approved at 3%, but since you had no beforehand knowledge of this, you have no idea what's a good rate and what's not. Well, these folks are signing in at 5 or 6% interest rate, but they got approved at 3%. And the reason why is the bank lets the dealer keep whatever they mark the interest rate up to. And in other words, they get you approved at 3%, but they sign you at 6%. Well, guess what? You just overpaid by thousands on financing. At Parkway RV Center, you don't have to worry about that. We only do what the bank approves you for. We don't mark the interest rate up. We don't believe in it. We believe in offering financing as a courtesy to our buyers, not as a way to make money and overcharge them. And that's why we can get you an interest rate on this RV lower than what you could buy one brand new for. And of course, this thing brand new is well into the six figures. So don't fall victim to that. If you go to another RV dealership that has a finance or business manager, save yourself some money. Go ahead and go to your bank or credit union, get pre-approved, and that way you know you're not overpaying for interest. And folks, like I said, 3% interest rates, even if you're a cash buyer, I can't tell you how many cash buyers that we have that actually say, of course, it don't matter to us, first of all, if you pay cash or you finance. There's actually less paperwork involved when you finance over a cash buyer, thanks to the good old U.S. federal government. But that's a whole different topic. But anyway, even if you're a cash buyer, 3% interest rate, folks, it's worth that to keep your cash and finance the RV. And even if you're on a budget, let's say you've got $10,000 cash, you want to buy a $10,000 motorhome or $15,000 motorhome, but you don't want to buy one that's older that you got to work on. Well, this is a great way to get a nicer, newer motorhome that you can start using instead of putting it in the shop and working on it. Keep your cash and only pay a few hundred dollars in interest with that 3% interest rate. So just something to keep in mind, folks. And also, we have nationwide delivery. If you want this motorhome delivered anywhere in the country, you just pay whatever it costs us to get it to you and get my driver back home, not a dollar more. If you want to come pick it up, you're welcome to fly into Chattanooga, Tennessee Airport. We'll pick you up for free during business hours and bring you back here. My RV techs will go over the motorhome with you, and you can drive it home. You know, you can fly in here from, and I have buyers fly in every week. California, I've had them fly in from Canada, Alaska. I've sold RVs all over the country and beyond, folks, and they fly in from everywhere. And you can fly in here for less than $500 from pretty much anywhere in the continental United States. Spend a few hundred bucks in fuel and driving the RV home, have a nice vacation, nice little trip, and save yourself some money. Because you compare our prices to anybody, nobody touches us, folks. That's why we've been in business for as long as we have, and that's why we sell as many RVs as we do. Give us a call, 706-965-7929, evenings and Sundays. And write this, well, I mean, go ahead and write both numbers now, but take particular attention to this next number I'm going to give you. After Hours Sales, 423-605-6747. You know, we're a multi-million dollar RV dealership. We've got 150 plus used RVs. How many dealers our size are going to disclose on our all of our advertising and all my videos our company owner's personal cell phone number? That's what that 423 number is, folks. That's how confident we are in the quality of our RVs, and that's how confident we are in our prices, that we're willing to give you our company owner's personal cell phone number. So if you want to call and talk to him after the office is closed, you're more than welcome to. That's how confident we are, folks. And I promise you, there's not another dealer out there our size that's discloses their boss's personal cell phone number, but we do, folks. We're very transparent as we can possibly be. And that's why our buyers love us, folks. We don't have commissioned salespeople. That saves you a ton of money, too, because another reason why these other RV dealership prices are so much higher than us is they use commissioned salespeople. You don't realize it, but when you buy something from a commissioned salesperson, you're overpaying by thousands when it comes to an RV. The reason why is other RV dealers use commissioned salespeople. This way they can keep 30 or 40 salespeople or however many they want on staff at any given time. They never have to pay them, folks. They don't have to pay them by the hour. They don't have to pay them salary. They only get paid when they produce a sale. So it doesn't hurt the dealer's feelings to have 100 RV salespeople on a lot our size. Well, the bad thing about it is the average RV commission rate is 25% of the gross profit. So that means these big RV dealers have to mark their prices up an additional 25% to cover the salesperson's commission. Folks, I'm going to tell you, so in other words, that salesperson that's been pressuring you, that playing games with you, that you eventually buy an RV from, you're paying him thousands of dollars out of your own pocket, because that dealer marked those prices up to cover their commission. I don't know about you folks, but I haven't met anybody that's worth me paying them thousands of dollars for just for them to sell me an RV. At Parkway RV Center, all my salespeople are salary based only. There's no high pressure sales tactics. There's no pressure at all. My guys, as far as their checks concerned, they don't care if you buy this motorhome or don't buy it. This way they work for you, answering any questions you have. There's no selling involved, because I know I got the lowest prices on the internet, but they answer your questions, help arrange trade-ins and financing if you need it, and of course they schedule a time for delivery or to have you pick it up. That's what they get paid to do. So as far as their paycheck's concerned, it doesn't matter to them whether you buy this RV or not. So that's a great concept. Our buyers love it that way. Instead of having to work against a commissioned salesperson, you've got a salary-based salesperson that's working with you, not are working for you, not against you. So keep that in mind, folks. That's the way we've done it for almost half a century. Our buyers love it that way. There's no pressure. There's no gimmicks. There's no fake sales, no turnovers, none of that junk like you see at a commissioned sales lot. Thank you for watching my video. You can email us, sales@parkwayrvcenter.com. Our website is parkwayrvcenter.com or parkwayrvcenter.net. They're both mobile friendly. Very easy to use. I've got links to my YouTube channel. You can subscribe to it so you get notifications every time I post a video, and I usually try to do a couple a day. I don't have everything posted online, but folks, over the next few weeks, I'm going to be working really, really hard to get our website updated. And I'm going to be working so much that I pretty much temporarily relieve myself of all my other duties besides shooting videos and putting these units online. So I will get caught up here in the next few weeks. But what I tell people to do in the meantime, if you go to our website, you don't see what you're looking for, call one of my non-commissioned salespeople, get to know them, let them get to know you. We may have your motorhome sitting here on our lot right now at a price thousands lower than anybody else in the country has the same RV for. And you may not even know it because it's not posted online. So my RV salespeople can send you pictures of it, answer any questions you have, and sell it to you before it goes online. Because once these RVs go online with videos, and I use about 20 different websites, they're gone in a matter of days because of our prices. I go on eBay, 20 other different websites, and you can check my eBay feedback. I'm a certified power seller on eBay with hundreds of positive feedbacks from people that have bought RVs from me from all over the country. As far as I know, I'm the only used RV dealership that's a certified power seller on eBay. I've also got dozens of customer testimonials, positive customer testimonials on my Google Plus page, again, from customers that came from all over the United States and bought from us. So I'm not going to risk that reputation to sell you a motorhome that may have unforeseen problems, or sell you a motorhome that we're not going to do what I say we're going to do. We're going to go through that big checklist on this RV. We're going to make sure everything works. Like I said, I've got the air running, fridge on, lights on. As far as I can tell already, everything works. But I'm not an RV tech, and my RV techs will go through this thing and check it before you pick it up or we deliver it. Thank you for watching my video. I hope to see everybody soon here in beautiful Ringgold, Georgia. I'm not in sales. I'm in marketing, but if you so I don't take calls at all, folks. But if you want to email me directly, just ask me questions about anything. My email address is bo@parkwayrvcenter.com. That's the best way to contact me. Thank you for watching my video, and again, hope to see y'all soon here in beautiful Ringgold, Georgia.